I've got what is called a cold flare, which is, well, at least in Denmark, a legal flare. So instead of the illegal Bengals. We don't use them yet, but we just got these in November and are waiting for everything to just come into place before we can use them in the stands. But they will be used as choreos. They were designed by a pyrotechnician called Tommy, who lives in Denmark. He's kind of a mad scientist, so he was just messing around at home and he saw in the news that the club I represent as well, called Brøndby, got another pyro fine. So he was just kind of messing about, you know, how could you do pyros without all the fines? So yeah, he came up with this and he contacted us with the story of, I can save football in Denmark. So. And then, you know, 3-4 years later, we finally have a product that we can use in the stands. They cost 8.5 euros a piece, so they're a bit expensive. But then again, they're completely legal. They are CE approved and they've been tested at a German factory as well. So they are classified as no kind of table bombs. So there's no problem in using these. In Denmark, at least, they put it equivalent to, you know, hooligan fighting, violence. It's like we're killing children with this. But at the same time, they celebrate it in when we have it in the stands. So it's, you know, it's kind of a, you know, figure out what foot to stand on, because they do also appreciate a good pyro show, or some of them do. Can pyro be safe? It can absolutely be safe, and also the pyro that is used today can be used in a safe manner. But we are having difficulties convincing the authorities on this, so that's why we are trying to work towards this. But it will not eliminate the pyros that we see now. It will just be a supplement.